You did it. You sealed all three of the realm tears. How do you feel?
Like my fingers are about to fall off.
You have come a long way, Atreus. This was no easy feat. You should feel pride.
I do. Thank you, Father.
Need a fresh upgrade?
Hey, Sindri, guess what? We closed all the realm tears.
You what? No, you did not. You really did? No way.
Yes, huh? It took forever, but we sealed them all up.
I don't believe it. The strength you would need.
It is no boast.
No, I suppose you aren't the type. Well, not much else I can say besides thank you. Evaldian sons would thank you too, were they here. Let's get to it. Or never mind then.
once more to the horn.
Finish that story you started?
We need only conclude the Song of Bergelmir, founder of Jotunheim, who chose love instead of revenge.
Bergelmir the Beloved. Huh. I've never heard a story end that way. Not a true one, anyway.
You do, laddie.
Wonder what happened to this ship's crew. Something down there. Mimir, is there a story for the giant with the flaming sword?
Suit the brave. Of course. We've spoken so much of frost giants. It's about time we instead met the most fiery giant of all. Back when Ymir first emerged from Ginnungagap, it was Surt who followed next. He came from Muspelheim, the fire realm, bringing heat to the young cosmos, conjuring the sun from his primordial flame. But let's come back to that flaming sword, shall we? Surt the Brave forged his sword of flame for one purpose alone. To burn down Asgard when Ragnarok comes at last.
And we'll pick this up later.
Thank you.
Say we finish that story.
Stuart the Brave and his Sword of Flame, fated to burn down Asgard come Ragnarok. His destiny is to fall at the hands of Thor and Odin, but in so doing, strike the blow that leaves their realm in ash and ruin. And from that destruction, the world can be born anew. Until then, alone he waits in Muspelheim, never sleeping, ever honing his fiery blade. Brave, generous suit, who knows he lives but to his doom. All because he chooses to serve a grand cycle so much bigger than himself. To truly embrace your purpose and the patience and sacrifice it demands is to ensure your day will come.
Do you think we'll be there when that day comes?
I've seen enough of war between the gods, but you, little brother, who can say?
Atreus, follow me.
Sorry, I got distracted.
Sure is a lot to see here.
What does it say?
Yes, sir. Death to the Raven God, Lord of the Hanged.
That's talking about Odin. He's known by many names. Not all of them nice.
Here, boy.
I know those runes. That's Vindr. Wind. Must be for that sand bowl down there.
Draw it.
Sir. Vindr. Look what it did!
Thank you.
are one vicious son of a bitch.
So what'd you find out there? Moving on. Then. Now you're talking, son.
Thank you.
You hitting the road or chewing the fat?
It might still be in his stomach. And he's open to letting you go into his mouth to look inside.
Ew. Really?
By the by, he's not wild about it either.
So, are we really doing this? Letting the serpent swallow us?
You do not have to come.
Well, I'm not gonna miss this. This is a good idea?
No.
Well, brothers, I've been to many strange places, but this will be a new one.
Yeah. I've never been in a giant's belly either. How about you, Father?
Never one that was not trying to eat me.
You really should expect that sort of response at this point.
About getting eaten.
Dreams are nothing.
I'm not afraid. It just reminded me of a way I used to feel when I was a child. Let's find that statue.
Ah, smells not as bad as I thought it'd be. Bit like heather ale fermenting. Rather pleasant, actually.
You're so weird. The water kind of burns in here. That is water, isn't it?
Aye.
There, the hammer.
Freeze the hand, we're good. Odin hid your eye?
No, it's not like I can still see through it.
Yep, that's an eye.
Maybe you should stick that in my head, for safekeeping. Gently now, gently. Thank you, brother. You don't miss depth until it's gone. Well, I wouldn't say I'm feeling whole again, but it's a right improvement.
The Bifrost is intact.
It'll serve.
Then we have all we need.
Finally, we're going to Yodna. There's no stopping us now.
Laddie, have you ever heard the term tempting fate?
Fate is another lie told,
by the gods, yes, of course. You really are your father's son, you know. Well, that was mildly terrifying. Maybe our presence is upsetting Jormungandr's belly.
No. Something is wrong.
What's happening to him?
Nothing good!
Glad that's over.
Is he getting hit? What is that?
We must hurry.
Couldn't agree more, brother.
This. What happened to him? Something we did?
No. Something else. A dead giant. Why would the serpent leave us here?
Look! Freya. can still trust her, right?
Until we know for certain, keep her distance.
The world serpent. What's happened here?
We hoped you would know.
You are far from home.
I'm looking for my son. The two of you. You helped me see things more clearly.
You do not know where he is then?
No. But the woods and fields speak his name. I know he walks here in Midgard.
When did you see him last?
Long ago. Before you were even born. Why are you standing so far from me? What's wrong? Something's happened.
There!
I had a feeling that hurting the big snake would bring the two of you out in the open. Do you have any idea? Any idea at all? What you have cost me.
My boy.
Mother.
I'm here. Don't run away.
Oh, I'm not going anywhere, Mother.
I know that you're still angry. I know that how you feel hasn't changed, but I want you...
How I feel? How I feel? I've spent the last 100 years dreaming of this moment. I've rehearsed everything I ever wanted to say to you, every word, to make you understand exactly what you stole from me. But now, I realize I don't need you to understand anything. I don't need you at all.
No, back off, Kratos. This has nothing to do.
This path you walk. Vengeance. You will find no peace. I know.
You? I'll deal with you later. But family first. This again? Turn away, boy. This won't be pretty.
I won't let you hurt him.
No, boy.
Fine.
Stop! Ah! No! No! Atreus! You're bleeding. Breathe, boy. Breathe!
Not my blood.
What is this? I can feel this. Oh. I can feel everything.
No! He's vulnerable now? us?
No. Do you hear the wind? We are moving.
That arrow. Balder punched the mistletoe?
In the quiver strap, yes. The mistletoe harmed him.
Freya said it was wicked.
He's more than harmed. The spell is broken.
He can be killed.
I'm certain of it. It's all coming back now.
Now he remembers.
Him.
No, woman! You cannot! He means to kill you!
You can't stop me! No one can!
Where is he?
I don't care if he kills me. I will protect him. I will not let him die!
How touching. This will all be over soon.
Mother! Oh, mother!
Father himself could not. I've never felt more alive. Ironic, isn't it? What?
Thank you. Come on! Do it! Do it!
Stop! Please!
He's beaten Father. Not a threat.
You will not come for us again. You will not touch her.
I don't need your protection.
Interfering in my life!
I was just trying to protect you! I've made mistakes, I know. But you're free now. You have what you want. Try to find forgiveness. We can build something new.
Never forgive. You still need to pay for the lifetime that you stole from me.
I have paid. I have paid. But if that alone will make you whole, if seeing me dead we'll make things right. I won't stop you.
I know.
Violation imaginable upon you. I will parade your cold body from every corner of every realm and feed your soul to the vilest filth in hell. That is my promise.
He saved your life.
He robbed me of everything. Everything. You were just an animal. Passing on your cruelty and rage, you will never change.
And you do not know me.
I know enough. Does he?
Boy. Listen close. I'm from a land called Sparta. I made a deal with a god that cost me my soul. I killed many who were deserving. And many who were not. I killed my father.
That was your father in hell. Is this what it is to be a god? Is this how it always ends? Sons killing their mothers? Their fathers?
No. We will be the gods we choose to be. Not those who have been. Who I was is not who you'll be. We must be better.
Well, guess we are the bad guys now.
In her eyes, yes. But she could never make that choice. Finish this journey while I still have strength.
I don't understand. I know saving her was the right thing, but she seemed all evil at the end.
Not evil. You killed her son, lad. Her son. The death of a child is not something a parent gets over easily.
But he was gonna kill her.
She would have died to see him live. Only a parent can understand.
So you'd let me kill you?
If it meant you would live. Yes.
Look, there was no easy choice. For anybody, brother. But I think we can all agree you did the right thing. The world's a better place with Freya in it. Just give her time, lads. She'll come around.
Back to Tyr's Temple, then. One last time.
Aye. Jotunheim awaits.
Why did Baldur say we cost him?
Odin must have convinced him that following you to Jotunheim would bring his cure. Lies, I'm sure.
Why did Mistletoe?
Vanir magic is powerful, but it rules are slippery and elusive. I'm sure it makes sense if you're a witch. It's also bloody tragic. Baldur was the greatest gift Odin granted Freya, the one thing she treasured from their marriage. She only hoped to spare him pain and spare herself loss. And such impulses can lead good parents to make terribly stupid decisions. Go ahead and lock in Jotunheim and we'll be on our way. Probably.
Hope this doesn't cause you to explode or anything.
Oh, hadn't considered that. Maybe we should talk about this a bit more.
Nah, I'm sure he'll be fine. Ready.
That's unpleasant!
Now, boy! We must be close.
Well, what are we waiting for? Think it's far?
We will see.
A word, please, before we continue. Listen, the last thing you two need up there is a decomposing heat ruin in the moment. Why don't I wait for you here? This is between you and the boy.
True. But if someone were to fight...
My Lady Sif's soft, perfect sloshers. You done did it.
Sorry. We had to see this.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. Fine, damn it. Fine.
Watch the head till we return.
I can do this. No, no, I can't. Oh.
Okay.
Ready. Come.
Look! We're on the giant's fingers. I can see the highest peak ahead. Right over there. We did it.
We did.
What are you doing?
I have nothing more to hide.
Can we go now? We're so close.
Boy. Boy.
It's nothing. I just thought I'd hear voices by now. Hello? Anybody here?
Why carve all these faces?
What if this is all the giants that got out of Midgard alive? Not really many at all. Odin and Thor, ruining everything for everybody. Huh. Who's the guardian? I should feel them, but I don't. This place is dead. What happened to them? Why'd Mom send us here?
One question is answered, and two more take its place.
Wait! Father! Something's happening! Muller. Look. She's arguing with a bunch of giants. She knew giants? That's us. The first time we met the world serpent. But how? And our fight with Baldur. Just happened. Wait. They knew everything that was going to happen. The dragon in the mountain. The stone mason. All these drawings. This is our story.
No. This is your story.
But... what does it all mean?
That I was not the only parent with secrets.
You didn't know. She was a giant. I'm a giant. Why didn't she tell us?
She sent us here, knowing we would find this.
But why not just tell us the truth?
Your mother would have had good reasons. Baldur was never sent to find me. He was tracking her all along, not knowing she was only ashes.
If she had a plan for us, I trust it. Whatever it is. Besides, she hasn't been wrong yet. Come on. We're so close to the end now.
Yes. Yes, we are.
Look, it's Mother's. She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us. Watching over us. Leading us home. Let's finish it. Father?
No. We do it together. Son.
There's nothing for us here.
Come.
So, I get that Mother was a giant. Which makes me part giant and part god.
And part mortal.
Right. I guess there's just one thing I don't understand. My name on the wall. Giants called me Loki.
Loki. That's the name your mother wanted for you when you were born. She must have called you that to her people.
But why?
A question for another day. Let us go home.
Makes sense now. Why she want to end up here? Be with her kind? But did she know it was going to be like this here? Is this what she wanted us to see? Did she want us to tell the people? Or keep it a secret?
I do not know.
So what should we do?
I trust you to decide that.
Oh. So why do you want to name me Atreus? I know it can't be for a god.
No. He was a soldier. A Spartan.
A great warrior?
All Spartans are great warriors. We trained from birth. Our lives were discipline, duty, battle, and death. Life was grim, and we greeted it grimly. But Atreus of Sparta was unlike the rest of us. He wore a smile even in the worst of times. He was happy. He inspired us to hope. That though we were machines of war, yet there was humanity in us. Goodness. When the day came for him to lay down his life in battle, his sacrifice saved countless others and turned the tide in our favor. I carried him home on his shield and buried him with all the honors of Spartan custom. His memory was a comfort in dark times.
Wow! You actually told a good story. We missed it. I understand if you want to go home, but maybe helping people is part of why Mom sent us out here, too. I mean, what would Atreus of Sparta do?
And what would Loki do?
Huh. That's a weird name. I'm glad we went with yours.
Am I glad to see you? I believe
believe I've reached my limit for dwarven charm.
What happened, Mimir?
They took an uncomfortable number of measurements and then proceeded to bicker about the weather.
Where do you want us to take you?
How about the warm confines of anywhere bloody else? Return to Midgard, I should warn you. More time has passed than you might realize. The snowfall that began when you slew Baldur, it's become something else. The stuff of omens.
Omens for the coming of winter.
Not just any winter, but a great winter to span three summers. It's done. Ragnarok begins.
Ragnarok from snow.
Aye, snow. Lots more snow. And then the end of the bloody world. In that approximate order.
Another prophecy.
No, brother. Prophecy doesn't expect this for 100 more winters at least. You've changed something. Prophecy didn't count on you.
I'm telling you, it's Fimbulwinter. I can feel it in my throat. This is the big one.
Stop saying that. Oh, you're making me very nervous. It was bound to snow sooner or later.
That ain't just snow, and you know it. It's the end times.
How dare you make me the voice of reason?
Guys?
Just discussing the weather. Bit of a cold snap lately.
What he means is, Fimbulwinter's upon us, boys. The winner to end all winters. I can feel it in my throat.
Yeah. We heard.
So, if you're heading home, try to keep moving. And also, to not die.
Or if you're not heading home, same advice.
Brothers, there's another thing I must let you know from the time you were away in Jotunheim.
Well, tell us then.
It concerns Freya. She paid me a visit.
What did you tell her?
What little I know about where Odin may have kept her Valkyrie wings. Seems she's rather bent on reclaiming her warrior spirit. I'm afraid the cycle of vengeance may not be so easily broken.
Like a lifetime ago.
Bit drafty, maybe. It's a right improvement over having tree bark in your tadger.
Time to rest.
I'm gonna sleep through winter.
Okay, this'll do.
Sleep.
Way ahead of you.
Ball. Atreus, are you ready?
Yeah, but I had the weirdest dream. Fimbulwinter was ending, and Thor came for us, here at the house.
It was only a dream.
But it felt different. It felt real. It felt like the future.
Then we will worry about it tomorrow. Today, there are still things we can do. Come.